Hi, welcome to Nagesh Biology Online Classes. Those who have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, like and share to your friends. Let's discuss about a topic, fermentation. Fermentation, otherwise known as zymosis. Entire fermentation process, that is anaerobic respiration, because this process do not use oxygen in any step. So this process, it is anaerobic respiration. Oxygen is not utilized in any step. In any step of fermentation or zymosis process, oxygen is not utilized. So this process is called anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration first time discovered by Gay-Lussac scientists. We can conduct fermentation process in one specialized vessel. We can demonstrate this process. A specialized vessel. That vessel is known as Kuhne's vessel. This Kuhne's scientist designed a special apparatus or vessel. In that vessel, we can conduct this process. Kuhne, it is name of the scientist. He made one vessel. That in that vessel total anaerobic conditions are maintained. So we can conduct fermentation process in Kuhne's vessel. Fermentation process broadly divided into two types based on end products. The total entire fermentation process, two types. The first type, lactic acid fermentation. Second type, alcoholic fermentation. So both the process did not require oxygen, but what base, they are broadly divided into two types based on the end products. If the end product is lactic acid, the type of fermentation, lactic acid fermentation. If the end product is alcohol, the type of fermentation, alcoholic fermentation. But in fermentation process, glycolysis also involved. Entire fermentation process occurs in cytosol or cytoplasm of the cell because it is a anaerobic process. But whereas in aerobic process, the mitochondria that is involved for link reaction and the Krebs cycle, ETS. But whereas total all the steps, whatever occurs in fermentation process, all the events, all the reactions are catalyzed in only cytoplasm of the cell. Total fermentation, it is a cytosolic process, or we can say it is all the reactions occurs in cytoplasm. How lactic acid is produced, how alcohol is producer, that we will discuss detail information. Now we discuss detail information about lactic acid fermentation. The first type of fermentation, lactic acid fermentation. The lactic acid fermentation, lactic acid is end product. That's why this process is called lactic acid fermentation. Where we can observe lactic acid fermentation? We can observe lactic acid fermentation in lactic acid bacteria and as well as you can observe in our muscle cells. Whenever inadequate amount of oxygen available to muscle cells, the during exercises oxygen is not available sufficient amount to muscle cells. Whenever inadequate or insufficient amount of oxygen available to muscle cells, lactic acid is formed. Now, how lactic acid fermentation occurs? Total entire this process occurs in cytoplasm of the cell. So we have to consider for lactic acid fermentation glycolysis process also. How exactly this mechanism occurs in lactic acid bacteria? Once you will see here, first respiratory substrate, that is glucose, it is simple carbohydrate that enters into the glycolysis process. At the time of conversion of glucose to 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, net gain of ATPs, 2 ATPs are formed. Net gain, 2 ATPs. Total in glycolysis, 4 ATPs are produced, but whereas 2 ATPs are consumed during beginning of the glycolysis steps, or first and third steps. The net gain of ATP is 2 ATPs at the time of conversion of glucose to pyruvic acid. And as well as here, 2 molecules of NADHH plus also produced, that is 6th step. During oxidation step, 2 NADHH plus also produced. So here the glucose, it is a 6 carbon compound, but whereas pyruvic acid, it is 3 carbon compound. So, 1,6 carbon compound glucose, it will split into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid, that is, so 3 carbon compound. But here 3 carbon compound, 2 molecules are produced. Entire this conversion, glucose to pyruvic acid, that process, what do you call, already we discussed earlier, glycolysis. Glycolysis also involved in a fermentation process, that may be lactic acid or alcoholic fermentation. We have to consider all the events of glycolysis also for lactic acid fermentation. But in glycolysis, end product pyruvic acid. Once you will see the pyruvic acid formula, CH3COCOOH. This is a 3 carbon compound, 1, 2, 3. So 3 carbon compound is formed, that is pyruvic acid. This pyruvic acid, that is reduced to lactic acid in lactic acid fermentation. Lactic acid is formed. Lactic acid formula C3H6O3. Lactic acid, how many molecules are formed? 2 molecules of lactic acid formed during reduction process. But here once you observe, pyruvic acid is 3 carbon compound. Lactic acid also 3 carbon compound. Number of carbons are not reduced at the time of conversion of pyruvic acid to lactic acid. But here the pyruvic acid converts into lactic acid. That process is known as reduction process. The process of conversion of pyruvic acid to lactic acid, that complete process reduction. Once you observe, whatever NADH produced in glycolysis, that is the most important point. In the glycolysis, 2 NADHH plus are produced during 6th step at the time of oxidation step. Whatever NADH produced in glycolysis, those NADH are used in at the time of conversion of pyruvic acid to lactic acid. 2 molecules of NADHH plus, this one oxidized to 2 molecules of NAD plus. This NADHH plus oxidized, this is reduced. So here the reducing compound, that is NADH, reducing compound in this process, NADHH plus, it is oxidized, it is reduced. This is because of oxidation, this will produce as releases electrons and protons. Those electrons, protons are used by pyruvic acid to form lactic acid. But here, the once you observe carefully, whatever NADH produced in glycolysis, those NADH completely used at the reduction step of the lactic acid fermentation. So here the net gain, total final net gain of lactic acid fermentation only 2 ATPs, that is produced in glycolysis step. Here lactic acid fermentation, if we will take this process, we have to start from glucose 2 and we have to end with lactic acid. So lactic acid fermentation, that we have to consider total glycolysis and reduction. We should not consider only conversion of pyruvic acid to lactic acid. You have to consider glycolysis and reduction. So glycolysis, reduction of pyruvic acid, these two steps we have to consider as lactic acid fermentation. That's why here glycolysis, it is a common pathway for anaerobic respiration and as well as aerobic respiration. The lactic acid fermentation, it includes glycolysis and as well as reduction process. The pyruvic acid reduced to lactic acid, this glycolysis reduction, both the steps together call lactic acid fermentation. So total all these changes occurs in cytoplasm of the cell. This reduction process, that is occurs presence of one enzyme, that is lactate dehydrogenase. This is one enzyme. Presence of this enzyme only pyruvic acid reduced to lactic acid. This lactate dehydrogenase enzyme, otherwise known as lactic acid dehydrogenase, this enzyme or catalyst helps to reduction of pyruvic acid to lactic acid. But in this process, carbon dioxide is not produced in any step of the glycolysis or reduction time. Pyruvic acid reduced to lactic acid, there is no liberation, there is no production of carbon dioxide. So this total entire process is called lactic acid fermentation. This process also you can observe in our muscle cells during heavy exercises. So due to lack of sufficient amount of oxygen for the glucose, then it enters into the lactic acid fermentation. Net gain of ATPs in lactic acid fermentation, only 2 ATPs. Why we should not calculate NADH? Because in glycolysis 2 NADH are produced. Those NADH only used at the time of reduction process. So the net gain of ATPs, that is 2 ATPs, that we have to calculate the glycolysis net gain ATP. Second process is alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation we can observe in yeast cells. So well-known examples for alcoholic fermentation, yeast cells. Some general points we'll discuss related to alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation, it is a common type of anaerobic respiration. This is also a type of fermentation only, but in this process alcohol is produced. Its most common type of anaerobic respiration, alcoholic fermentation. You can observe in yeast cells this process. Yeast cells are well known examples for unicellular fungus. It's a well known example for unicellular fungus. Next, alcoholic fermentation process end products. We will see the end products of alcoholic fermentation. So mainly end products what will form? Ethyl alcohol is formed. Next, CO2 molecules are produced. Two molecules of ATP is also produced. Two molecules of CO2. Two molecules of ethyl alcohol. For one glucose molecule, you can see here, for one glucose molecule, all the molecules, two only formed in alcoholic fermentation. But in alcoholic fermentation, in this process, whenever alcohol percentage reaches 13%, that is poisonous to yeast cells. 13% of alcohol, whenever reaches in the glucose solution, that 13%, more than 13% alcohol, that is a poisonous to yeast cells. So all the yeast cells are killed. Whenever alcohol percentage reaches 13%, then that total 13% of alcohol poisonous to yeast cells. All yeast cells are killed. So the yeast cells are alive, or they can survive less than 13% of alcohol at the time of formation of alcohol in the process. Total all these reactions occurs in cytoplasm of the cell. All the events, whatever occurs, the total glycolysis process also included in alcoholic fermentation process. Total all the events occurs in cytoplasm of the cell. So the most important point, only less than 7% of glucose energy that is released in this process. Total, when you compare with aerobic respiration, so very less amount of energy that is liberated in the alcoholic fermentation process, only less than 7% of glucose energy released. But these values are examination point of view important. 13% of alcohol toxic or poisonous to yeast cells. Less than 7% of glucose energy that is released in alcoholic fermentation. This process, it is partial oxidation of glucose. That lactic acid fermentation also partial oxidation of glucose. But complete oxidation means that is aerobic respiration. It is complete anaerobic respiration. Total alcoholic fermentation, it occurs in mainly two steps. First step is called decarboxylation. So because of elimination of carbon dioxide from pyruvic acid, the first major step, that is decarboxylation. Second step is known as reduction. So these are the major two steps occurs in alcoholic fermentation. In the first step, carbon dioxide is released. Second step, because of reduction process, reduction step, two molecules of ethyl alcohols are produced. We'll discuss what are the enzymes are involved during decarboxylation, what type of enzyme involved in reduction in the both the steps. Net gain of ATP is in this process. Total 2 ATPs, whatever produced in glycolysis, that those ATPs only we have to count for alcoholic fermentation. Exactly how this mechanism occurs in the form of flowchart we'll discuss. Once we will see the detailed information about alcoholic fermentation with the help of a flowchart. So the first glucose, it is a common simple carbohydrate that is used during lactic acid fermentation and as well as alcoholic fermentation. It is the most common simple carbohydrate that enters into the all the process, that may be lactic acid fermentation or alcoholic fermentation and as well as aerobic respiration. The first step, one molecule of glucose converts into two molecules of pyruvic acid. But pyruvic acid is 3 carbon compound, whereas glucose is 6 carbon compound. This process, that what we call, already we discussed earlier, that is glycolysis. in every step, every process, that may be lactic acid fermentation or alcoholic fermentation or aerobic respiration, glycolysis, it is the common process. Without glycolysis, we cannot expect either lactic acid fermentation, alcoholic fermentation or aerobic respiration. It is a major important common pathway that occurs in all living beings. During glycolysis process, total net gain of ADPs, so 2 ADPs are produced, and as well as 6th step, so 2 molecules of NADH, H plus also produced, that is at the 6th step, 2 NADH molecules are produced, that is in the glycolysis. But glycolysis process also included in lactic acid fermentation. So the mainly 2 major steps occurs in alcoholic fermentation. That is the first step, that is called decarboxylation. Second step is known as reduction. These are the major steps involved in alcoholic fermentation. It is glycolysis, it is common concept or common method that is involved in alcoholic fermentation. The major steps that occurs at the time of pyruvic acid to ethyl alcohol formation time. So the pyruvic acid, that is decarboxylated. Because of decarboxylation, 2 molecules of acetaldehyde molecules are produced. But at this process, at the time of formation of acetaldehyde from pyruvic acid, 2 molecules of CO2 released. Because we took here 2 pyruvic acid molecules. Because these 2 pyruvic acids are formed because of one single glucose molecule. 2 pyruvic acids are decarboxylated. So because of that, 2 molecules of CO2 released. This process, first step, that is decarboxylation. Removal of carbon dioxide during this step, that is called decarboxylation. It is the first step of alcoholic fermentation. Major first step. Carbon dioxide is released, first step of, that is alcoholic fermentation. Here the pyruvic acid 3 carbon compound, but whereas acetaldehyde it is 2 carbon compound, because 1 carbon removed in the form of carbon dioxide. That's why that is, so it is a 2 carbon compound, whereas pyruvic acid is 3 carbon compound. The process of conversion of pyruvic acid to acetaldehyde, that is decarboxylation, that process catalyzed by a enzyme. So because of that enzyme, so this process occurs in the cells. So the that enzyme name, pyruvic decarboxylase, that is one enzyme involved at the time of conversion of pyruvic acid to acetaldehyde. Now second step, that is the reduction step. And the reduction step, what happens, you will see here, major reduction step. At the time of reduction step, acetaldehyde, that is reduced to ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol, how many molecules are formed? 2 molecules. Ethyl alcohol formula C2H5OH. Here the major step, this is a reduction step. So the ones you will see here, this is a reduction step, second step. This is a step 2. Because the 2 major steps are involved in alcoholic fermentation. Step 1, decarboxylation. Because of decarboxylation, acetaldehyde is produced, that is 2 carbon compound. In reduction step, acetaldehyde reduced to ethyl alcohol. One most important point, whatever NADH produced in glycolysis, those NADH used at the time of reduction step. NADH, whatever produced in glycolysis, those NADH used in reduction step. two molecules of NADH H plus that converts into two molecules of NAD plus. This NADH that is oxidized. This compound is reduced. So reducing compound NADH, this will oxidize, this will reduce. So the reducing compound in this step, NADH. So whatever produced NADH in glycolysis, those NADH used in reduction step. That's why here the net balance at the time of calculation end products, we should not calculate NADH. Only ATPs only we have to calculate net gain of ATPs only. Two, this process occurs presence of one enzyme that is alcohol or alcoholic dehydrogenase. That is one enzyme, alcoholic dehydrogenase or alcohol dehydrogenase. So any one you can use, whatever enzyme involved in this second step, that is reduction step, alcoholic dehydrogenase or alcohol dehydrogenase. So once you observe for one glucose, net gain of ATPs produced in alcoholic fermentation, two ATPs, that glycolysis process ATPs only we have to calculate. Because so NADH produced in a glycolysis sixth step, they are used in a reduction step, that is the second major step of this process. So naturally fermented alcoholic beverages percentage will be less than 13%. So once you will see here, whatever naturally fermented alcohol percentage, naturally fermented alcohol percentage, it will be less than 13% only. Yeast cells are killed, so the beyond the 13% of alcohol, if the yeast cells are not found in the process, if the yeast cells are not involved, we cannot make more than 13% concentration, that is naturally. But nowadays, so some alcoholic beverages, we are preparing more than 13%, that is 20-25% alcoholic percentage also will be there. But that process, so fractional distillation, so whiskey, the alcohol percentage will be more than 13%. That is how it is possible, because of fractional distillation. So there is one method is there, that is a fractional distillation. This process helps to increase alcohol concentration. So the here the alcohol concentration we can increase, so because of fractional distillation process. The well-known example, more than 13%. So here the whiskey, alcohol percentage, it will be more than 13%. How it is possible? Because of a chemical process is there, fractional distillation process. Or one glucose molecule enters into the alcohol fermentation, end products are two ATPs and as well as two carbon dioxide molecules and two molecules of ethyl alcohol. So this is the most important point. End products of alcoholic fermentation, two ATPs, two carbon dioxide and two ethyl alcohols for one single glucose.